and the latest addition to the family, three-year-old Soleil.
Most people these days are getting drained, they're getting stressed, and yoga is a way of taking care of yourself.
Their favourite holiday is a retreat in France, known as Le Val Dieu, Valley of God.
Yoga is central to Le Val Dieu because it's there on offer, it fits well in the environment.
Like most teenagers, Nathan doesn't always agree with his parents.
We'd go on holidays, normally including a lot of spiritual-based mumbo-jumbo, circle-dancing tosh.
Le Val Dieu is not going to be a place for anyone that likes their thrills. It's for people who like silence and being, as my mother would put it.
For the Jeffreys, having a good time is always helped by a drink or two.
If we was to go out, we wouldn't go and have two drinks, we'd binge for a weekend.
Oh, God, that drinking. How many bottles of wine was there at the end of the 2 weeks?
72. 80 bottles.
The Seck family rarely drink and try to maintain a lifestyle that benefits both the body and the mind.
I can't drink, my body can't take drink. I would not drink lots of drink which would hurt my body just because other people are doing so.
On holiday, each family will have to live by the other one's rules. This could prove problematic for Olivia.
I'm very happy to follow rules that other people make as long as they feel right for me, and if they don't, then I tend not to follow them.
Chris has occasionally been known to have a drink or two. A week away with the Jeffreys will test him to his limits.
I feel like one of those cartoon films where you're in a little boat and it's coming along and you can hear the noise of the waterfall and you suddenly realise your boat is going to go over that waterfall. You don't know what's going to happen.
It's 6 a.m. and the Seck family are packed but still have no idea where they're going. The Jeffreys are already at the airport and are about to send a text message revealing all.
I'm going to send it. Yeah, does that sound all right?
Yeah, I think so.
OK. Come and join us in our Menorcan villa for fun, fiestas and a wild time. Adios. The Jeffreys family.
They're having a wild time?
Wild, I bet they're not wild, as wild as us.
In big letters.
Sounds good to me.
The Seck family set off for Menorca, ready to find out just what is wild about the Jeffreys. Spain is now the number one holiday choice for Brits, with more people opting for the Balearic Islands than anywhere else. Hiring a villa is ideal for a large family like the Jeffreys. Their villa will set you back around £1,500 for the week. The Jeffreys have already arrived at the villa and have decided to surprise the Seck family.
We're going to have a look and meet some people, people who live here. We're going to go and stay with them for a bit.
There's nobody here.
I can hear some noises in there.
Gosh,
you got scared, didn't you?
Did you drink?
No.
No,
no,
you don't drink alcohol.
Oh, we do.
Right, make some drinks then, Claire. I'll have a Bacardi diet.
What do you want to drink?
We've got
Fanta. I just want some water, actually.
Water, yeah, we've got water. Yeah.
The last time Chris had one too many was over a year ago. But tonight, he's decided to join the party.
You drink a little
bit. I can. No harm.
They seem quite nice. They do seem fine. But we're just going to enjoy this holiday. We've got loads of people coming around tonight anyway. We've got a big party. Hopefully get absolutely and go swimming. My mum goes skinny dipping.
And after 20 years of visiting the island, the Jeffreys know a lot of people.
A bit overwhelmed. Kind of big boo. Lots of people going, wow.
They're very friendly, yeah. No problems, really, at first. I mean, we've probably run into some differences, no doubt.
I haven't been around people drinking for quite a long time, on a regular basis, so it'll be interesting.
Olivia isn't keen to watch Chris competing with the Jeffreys on the drink front and heads off to bed.
See in the morning, Liz. See
in the morning.
Late.
Chris has had a few drinks while she's been to bed. He's just necked two Bacardis, and I mean necked. I drink and I don't neck them that quick.
going to have to watch that one, we are, boy.
Coming up, Chris gets tanked up.
There's a house in New Orleans.
And Claire gets worked up.
I'm not eating soggy veg and muesli with green stuff all over it. I just ain't doing it.
Put the fun back into driving. New Shaw Linen Dry. With motion sense that activates every time you move. Because to feel constantly new, you need constant protection. Shaw is the first antiperspirant with motion sense, and it gives you a constant level of protection. Shaw, it won't let you down. Whatever your style, whatever your day, feel constantly refreshed with a chance to win a French Connection outfit every day online, only with promotional packs of Shaw.
When it comes to lunchtime, we choose the same food over and over without paying attention to what we eat. Well, it's time for a fresh idea. Discover my delicious Uncle Ben's Rice Time. Specially selected vegetables and richly spiced sauces with fluffy steamed rice. Begin with my Uncle Ben's Rice Time and put taste back on the menu.
I've had an accident.
So what?
And I think I'm entitled to make a claim.
Not listening, underdog.
Okay, I'll call National Accident Helpline. Their legally trained advisors can tell me within minutes if they think I've got a claim, and they'll give me free advice with no obligation.
Free advice?
Ah, you heard that all right then.
However big they are, call National Accident Helpline on 0800 556 557.
Or go to underdog.co.uk.
A hotel in Barcelona. In a good central location. So yeah, something like this, but for two people.
With separate beds.
Sorry.
Come on, more stylish.
Okay.
More like it.
No way.
This one is perfect. Is there a pool?
Yeah, there is.
Trivago compares over 100 websites to find you your ideal hotel at the best price. Hotel? Trivago.
To be among the best in the world, I have to train 30 hours a week. But for my hair, it's simply torture. All the humidity can make it so frizzy. My solution? Hand Turn Smooth and Sleek. It helps me fight frizz, so even after all the training, my hair looks silky smooth. Because I want to win as an athlete and shine as a woman. Hand Turn Smooth and Sleek. Hair so healthy looking, it shines.
Flash gets rid of dirt and grime and grease in just a minute.
Flash will clean your whole house and most things you'll find in it. Can it clean a bathroom sink?
Quicker than a wink.
Can it clean a window sash?
Faster than a flash.
Can it clean a dirty mirror?
It'll make it bright and clearer.
Can it clean a diamond ring?
Flash cleans anything. Flash gets rid of dirt and grime. And
Flash, 50 years of shine and freshness.
Kate and I have been through 3 moves, 5 jobs, 2 newborns, and I'm getting grey. But Kate, she still looks like Kate.
Nice and easy with Colour Blend technology gives you beautiful tones and highlights in one simple step for colour that's true to you.
I don't know how she does it.
With the dimensional colour of Nice and Easy, all they see is you.
Vauxhall Corsa, with 0% APR representative, no minimum deposit, and you choose the payment term. That's flexible finance from Vauxhall.
Hello, my name's Keith Lemon. Welcome to my reality show.
ITV2 steps into the lifestyle of the sexiest man on telly.
This is my life, baby.
It's lavish. You look bang tidy.
It's a reality show, but with added... Lemon La Vida Loca, Thursday at 10 on ITV2.
It's the first morning of the villa holiday, and Chris has woken up with a sore head.
I was only a bit drunk last night. I was behaving myself. Within the last year, I've never been drunk, I don't think, not once.
Every day, the families have a breakfast meeting to discuss the day ahead. Claire and Lorraine are trying to round up the Seck family. The Jeffreys plan to kickstart the day with a local custom. It's an opportunity for Chris to double his annual alcohol intake.
We're going to go gin tasting.
Yeah. It's locally brewed.
Locally distilled gin that the island's quite famous for. And we're going to go down to the distillery and have a tour and do some tasting.
Then tonight, I'm going to be screeching into the mic. We're going to go karaoke tonight. So we're going to have a night out.
You don't have to sing.
So the idea is you go and get tanked up on gin and then you go and sing your heart out.
Yeah.
But before they make it to the gin factory, the Jeffreys are taking Olivia shopping to make sure there is enough food at the villa to cater for her veggie needs.
Lots of fruit. Best thing in the world.
Claire is keen to stock up on booze. And it's not just her family she's thinking of.
Chris was really drunk last night. What will he drink? Did he drink spirits?
He was drinking Bacardi and Coke yesterday.
Are you into more nutritious stuff than that? Yeah. I'm not. I'm Chris chocolate and sweets. Pizzas. McDonald's.
We're looking all right on it anyway.
They're not meat eaters. They don't eat cow's teeth. They don't drink proper milk. We walked in and... We went the sweets way, she went the organic way.
The gin tasting is in Mahon, the island's capital. In spite of his hangover, it doesn't take Chris long to get into the spirit.
Oh, I like that. What's that?
I thought you would. It's a herb.
Fantastic.
It's herbs. I thought you'd like it.
It's got fennel, isn't it? I get knocked down, but I go again.
Are those fans spinning?
Yeah.
Oh.
What parts of
he's
gin?
Actually a closet drinker, really. He's given a chance.
Finally, after all these years of repressing himself, he's actually coming out for real. You know, this is it.
It's gentian and herbs, but it does.
You're just putting the word herbs in.
Herbs, Olivia.
Come on, say herbs. You say the word.
Let go, you know. When in Menorca, do what the Jeffreys do. Yeah. No, I like that. That's really nice.
There's a sign above the door that says you're not allowed to leave until you've had 10.
Okay, well.
You've got to leave in double figures.
It says Phoenician herbs.
He's rushing, yeah.
Olivia today said to me that he doesn't drink that often, but when he does, it goes straight to his head. And I'll probably think that that is quite true because, you know, he did have a lot of liqueurs, but, you know, he was a bit wobbly when he came out and I thought, oh, God, we're going home.
Back at the villa, the kids are enjoying the pool and getting on famously. But after 15 shots of gin, Chris is paying the price.
I'm a bit tired, I think I'll have a rest. I'm not going to say I had 15 things of gin and I'm... Nah. I'm just having a rest.
Chris is learning to live, I think, again. Learning to live again.
And the drinking doesn't stop there. After a short pit stop, it's off to the local karaoke bar. Chris has never done karaoke. The Jeffreys are hoping if they ply him with enough alcohol, he will take centre stage. Claire is leading the way.
I'm so drunk. I don't know why I'm this drunk, you know. We came out at 10 o'clock and I've just been binging for hours. I'm really rude. I am blind. I'm not arm. He's really going to be hilarious. We are going to make your dad sing. Your dad is singing. Come on, you sit down, sit on your lap.
All right. Here we go.
Let's turn the mic on. Oh, I know it.
There is a house in New Orleans. They call her Rose.
I haven't seen a particularly different side of Chris this whole day. I've seen more of a previous side of Chris this whole day. This is what he was like a long time ago, until my mum converted him into her evil ways.
Unlike Chris, Olivia is struggling to join in with the Jeffreys holiday.
I have a limited tolerance to lots of alcohol around me. There comes a point where tonight I started to feel, after a certain point, I started to feel, just not the alcohol, actually, it's the whole thing, the noise, the just the whole atmosphere, where I just started to feel, gosh, I wish I was home with Soleil and reading my book, actually.
It's the day of the fiesta, which means more crowds and more drinking, Olivia's least favourite things. The Jeffreys go religiously every year, and the plan is to leave all the younger kids with a babysitter. But Olivia has decided she doesn't want to go.
I think I've got a change of plan.
Yeah?
Soleil's getting quite anxious. His right. voice is getting higher pitched, and he's going, oh, I don't want you to go, I don't want you to go. I'll give it a miss tonight. I just don't want him to get upset, and if he does get upset tonight, I won't be able to go anywhere for the weeks, and it's not worth it.
Then. It's a shame you're going to miss it, because you would have enjoyed it, but I do understand that, you know, that you want to be here for him.
As a single mum, Claire takes a different view to Olivia.
If I can leave my little boy, surely she can leave her little boy as well. She just sat there and said, oh, we decided not to come. My mum didn't bite back and say, well, no, this is our holiday and we want you to experience what we're doing. You know, it's, you know, they've got to do that. They, you know, we've got to do it on their holiday.
So it's up to Chris again to fly the flag for the Seck family. The Jeffreys are determined to show him just how much fun fiestas can be.
I think it's great, all this horses stuff.
You see him on the, horses now, look.
Claire and Richard are keen to touch the horse's heart. It's said to bring good luck, but Chris isn't prepared to go this far to join in.
I don't think Chris is enjoying it that much. He seems to think it's cruel, because the horses are very stressed, but I'll have a good time anyway, so that's all that matters.
I went up to one of the horses that had stopped and I just kind of was holding it, and I could feel that the horse was really stressed, and it was like champing a bit like this, you know. Okay, well, not sure about that really, but I think Olivia probably wouldn't have liked it very much, but I can't be sure.
I've seen her about 4 times in 5 days. Mm-hmm. Most of the time she's just hidden away in her room.
She was asleep all day today, wasn't she?
Yeah. Asleep all day today. Hidden away
boring,
in her...
boring, because all she eats is fruit.
And I think Christopher, he has just done such a great job of trying to get involved. He has been involved in everything. He particularly doesn't like the food that we eat, but he's eaten the food that we eat. He's been drinking, he doesn't drink, he hasn't had a drink in 2 years.
But after nearly a week of hard drinking, Chris has decided it's time to get back on the wagon.
I've personally reached a limit about how much of their way of living I can cope with. It's like there's a spring trying to pull me back a bit more to how I normally live myself.
And Lorraine has also reached her limit. She's had enough of picking up after the Seck family.
If everybody would just put away what they've used, it'd be so much more helpful to me to keep this place looking tidy. Chris is the worst. The antler of that fruit over there, it's all been cut open and just left. I've put pineapple in the fridge and fine, do it at home. You can't do it here.
She decides to raise the issue at the breakfast meeting.
I'm not complaining, I just want to say, when we get food out, can we make sure we put it away because of the ants? We've become infested. I've been round the house today and I've just constantly sprayed. You know, if everyone, when they use that, if they could just pop it in the dishwasher or anything, because, you know, me and...
My mum doesn't really like being rude to people, really. I mean, I'd be inclined to say, get up, get off your and help tidy up, you lazy.
It's the last day of the villa holiday, and with the air cleared, both families get up off their and head off to the Jeffreys' favourite beach, Salgar. Menorca has 120 sandy beaches, more than any of the other Balearic islands. Salgar, however, is more concrete than beach.
What about somewhere like that?
We can't go in there. It's part of the hotel. We're not allowed.
Chris has never snorkelled before, but as always, he's up for having a go.
Fairy tales can come true. It can happen to you. If you're young at heart, for it's hard, you will find, to be narrow of mind. If you're young at heart.
I don't know about doing karaoke again, but I'm definitely going to do that again. That was really fantastic. I enjoyed that.
It's not just Chris who's having his eyes opened. The holiday with the Sec family has also made Claire think about life as a single mum.
It's difficult to watch Chris bring Soleil up. Inside, deep down, I feel a bit gutted, really. I mean, Soleil's got his father here, and I haven't got a father here for Charlie. That's quite upsetting to say, really.
Parenting will continue to be a contentious issue, but not as contentious as the next destination, which the Sec family are about to reveal.
We're going to France.
Oh! Mm. What sort of things are we going to do there, then? What?
I'll give you a clue. Right.
Let's see.
Here it is.
Yeah, I got.
What time's the bar shut?
There isn't one.
So there's no where we can... Is there any alcohol involved?
Very little.
Right. And do we have to, like, eat the sort of foods that you eat?
It is vegetarian organic food.
But organic food doesn't mean that it's, you know... I mean, you can buy organic food.
Organic food tastes like...
Well, that might be, you know... That might be what you've experienced so far, and maybe you'll find out something new.
Mm. Mm. I've been wanting to do yoga for years, haven't I? Really.
I'm not eating any... I'm not eating... soggy veg and muesli with green stuff all over it. I just ain't doing it, do you know what I mean?
The family fly to Barcelona, then embark on the 180-mile journey through the mountains to reach the retreat.
She'll be coming round the mountain when she comes. She'll be coming round the mountain when she comes. Hidey high campers.
Jump off the mountain.
Don't laugh.
We have yoga in the big halls and bingo in the small halls.
Just wake me up when this nightmare's over, will you?
Chris makes the mistake of pulling over to show the Jeffreys the view of the mountains.
Hiya. We're not staying here, that's just somewhere we're visiting. We're just passing through it, yeah.
I know, but it's very dangerous. You know, Charlie's
it is quite
a
scary.
Different child to Soleil. Mm. Soleil is stuck to your hip 24/7, and unfortunately my son isn't. My son likes to explore.
Well, you can't let him explore here, that's for sure.
Yeah, I know, and that's what I'm saying, you know.
But surely we can only keep going up now, Chris. That's what I'm worried about. I'm really scared of heights, mate.
You gonna get out?
No, I'm scared of heights.
I'll hold your hand.
They're not even halfway there. This is going to be a long, tough journey, in more ways than one. Coming up, Lorraine loses her inhibitions.
I'm getting a bit involved there, mate.
And Claire loses her rag.
I am going home. My stuff is in the car, Charlie's strapped in, I'm going.
We'll be right back.
What happens when beauty meets strength? Dove knows women want to feel beautiful, but need strength too. What will more strength do for you? Dove Maximum Protection is clinically proven to give you twice the strength of the best-selling antiperspirant. Beautified with Dove's Caring 1/4 Moisturising Cream. Dove Maximum Protection, where beautiful women find strength.
Before the gold, silver, or bronze, it's the red. It's the green and yellow. It's the red, white, and blue. Because at the Olympic Games, it's not the colours you go home with that matter. It's the colours you came in. And when colours mean this much to you, you can trust them to Ariel. Team Ariel, proud keeper of our country's colours.
Go compare, go compare. When you ensure you...
Thousands of gorgeous products from all my favourite beauty brands at feelunique.com with great prices and free worldwide delivery. So, for all my colour, all my shine, something new, my must-haves, I just click to the UK's favourite online beauty store, feelunique.com, the destination for beauty.
MusicMagpie.co.uk is free and easy to use. Type the barcode of your unwanted CDs, DVDs and games, or scan with your webcam or smartphone and get an instant price. Ka-ching! Then use our free courier service or use our free post labels to pop them in the post. Lovely. Either way, you'll make loads more room and receive a cheque in next to no time. Easy. MusicMagpie.co.uk. Get cash for your old CDs, DVDs and games.
I've had an accident.
Who cares?
And I think I'm entitled to compensation.
Some chance, underdog.
OK, then. I'll call National Accident Helpline. Their legally trained advisors can tell me within minutes if they think I've got a claim. And their solicitors will sort everything out for me.
They'll sort everything out for you?
Not so big now, are you?
However big they are, call National Accident Helpline on 0800 556 557.
Or go to underdog.co.uk.
After a long journey, two very tired families arrive at Le Val-Dieu.
Building site.
Hello, Pat.
I think you've had a long journey, haven't you, darling?
They're greeted by Pat Cooper, who owns the retreat.
How are
you doing? Where's Florence?
Hello. This is actually it.
I'm going to get my stuff out in a minute anyway and just introduce myself to your sleeping really.
Do you want to come over and say hello to Pat?
Not that I know Pat, but hello. You're all right.
This is Claire.
All right.
This
Hi,
is
Claire.
Rachel.
Hi there.
This is Lorraine.
Oh my God, you're having a laugh, aren't you?
They're in, but they're staying in. They've got two double beds in there. It's obviously their holiday, so they get the best room.
It stinks. It's hippie. It is just so hippie.
Food is central to the Sec family holiday, and Pat provides breakfast and dinner, all strictly vegetarian and organic. Their welcome meal is lentil lasagna and tofu.
Is this the main course?
This is the entree, my dear.
Can I sit here?
You know, like, on our holiday, we let you shop for what food you wanted to shop for. We didn't make any rules, do you know what I mean, about organic stuff. So, you know, when we go shopping, can we get what we want to eat, or...
Well, we've got to talk about it.
What I offer you is what I offer everybody who is here staying, and you're not the only people. If you want to buy anything other than this, fine, it's no problem with me. But
no,
I do not
don't
offer.
Don't get me wrong or anything. Yeah. I think it's really lovely that you all eat healthy food and that, but to be honest, if it's going to be like this for 4 days, I'd rather starve.
If you want to buy your coats, I'm not against it, but that's not my trip and I don't offer that. Coming next is vegetarian lasagna and hope you enjoy stuff. Please.
Thanks, Pat.
Thank you.
Olivia has had enough of Claire's attitude and steps in.
I hope you had a good time here. Yeah.
But if you don't, we're sorry everybody else don't live like you.
No, I didn't say that.
It was something like that.
But if you don't, please don't let everybody else's life in misery.
We're not all hippies and we're not all, you know, eat food like this. And
you must try it one day because otherwise...
Maybe
dinner.
One day, but not tonight. Tonight I think tonight I'm
very long journey.
I know. I completely understand.
So maybe another time. It's quite enough to come to a new place without having to come... in the middle of the evening, after a long time like this, you know, I really do understand that. It's just trying to balance that out with being fair to Pat, you know, and not kind of making him feel like he's trashing the place. That's all.
If I wanted to trash the place, I'd live around.
You know what I mean? Just being kind of not upsetting her, really. Just respect, you know, basic. Mm. So to recap, the adult yoga tomorrow will start at 9 o'clock. It's just over there.
Normally a man of few words, Richard decides it's time to speak up.
Yeah, you never saw 9 o'clock in the morning alarm, did you?
No, I know.
Sorry. You can forget that tomorrow morning.
Lorraine is worried about Claire. She had her when she was very young and understands the pressures of being a teen mum.
She'll speak her mind and she's got every right and she's entitled to do that. And she did. I know how to deal with her. She's my daughter. I don't do it. I'd rather walk away than let her bite my head off.
I'm so angry. I'm just going to end up losing it. I'm going to go off my head. I really am.
The next morning, and there's been a storm in the night. Olivia has cancelled yoga to give everyone a lie-in. She's hoping the Jeffreys will wake up in a better mood. But Claire is about to prove she's far from finding inner peace.
Everything's so hard to eat, isn't it? It's all like...
Yeah, like, you know when you're waking up with a hangover in the morning?
And your mouth's dry.
Dry, and it's just like eating cardboard.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm eating cardboard.
Mm. I'm going to die. I'm off for stone night, I am, because I don't eat that. I don't eat yoghurt.
I don't drink that orange juice. The bananas are all bruised. Bread and water for us, eh?
Chris and Olivia have arranged for someone to come and give massages. But Claire wants to go riding.
Claire just needs to get rid of some cobwebs.
You know, if I go and ride and I go for a good gallop, maybe I can just get rid of all this anger inside me and start fresh, you know, because I can take it out on the horse then, do you know what I mean?
And if it clears and it gets very hot, then it's very hard to do horse riding here when it's very hot because the horses get bothered by the flies and all of that when it gets really, really hot. It says this is an
so
ideal
can we not
day
go
for
this
riding.
Morning, then? Being as we've got the yoga this evening. Because I really would like to go, like, shortly, you know, because I can go for a good ride then and be all fresh later for yoga.
It's probably not going to work because we've actually got people coming to do things here today.
I just want to go home.
What?
Who's taking me to the airport then? Because my stuff's outside ready, all packed, downstairs outside the car.
Chris,
I've
just been
speaking to you. Mum, I want to go home.
Mom.
I'm going home.
Mom.
Don't stand in this
Everybody needs to do what they feel they need to do, and I think, right. You know, it is... We're not here to look after anybody.
I think she stated pretty clearly that she needed to go and get the animal assistance. So we just need to say to you, like, OK, you can go to the airport if you want, but you can also get a horse and
what
kick
around.
What
do you want to say, Chris?
No one is going to change my mind. I am going home. My stuff is in the car. Charlie's strapped in. I'm going. I've had enough. I want to go. All right? I've really enjoyed our holiday. I've enjoyed driving up here, but I've had enough. I'm going home.
I'm not going to drive anymore.
Unfortunately, Claire can't drive, and no one's prepared to take her to the airport, so she decides to stay.
Just have to see what happens. But if anyone gets in my way again, I'm going to knock them out. I thought it was going to be real modern, do you know what I mean? And like a library with meditation in it and that, and all the incense and, you know, I was really looking forward to it, but it's just a heap of my house is better than this. I'm going to stay for today and see what happens, but, you know, I've got my passports ready, and if anything goes wrong, then I'm out of here.
Claire gets her own way and heads off into the Pyrenees to work off her negative energy, leaving everyone else to experience the Reiki and massages on offer. It's time for the big event of the day, the first yoga class. Everyone has turned up except Richard.
They're not making us feel welcome at all, and I don't see why I should play the game. You know, the only time Chris has spoke to me today is to tell me what I can eat, and oh, it's time for yoga.
Would you like just to lie down and relax?
The yoga will be taught by 79-year-old Bridget Litton Minor, who lives at Laval Dieu. Bridget might have the benefit of over 40 years teaching experience, but she's never had pupils like Lorraine and Claire.
Take a few deep breaths and just arrive.
Claire is smiling at last, but for all the wrong reasons.
Okay. Put your hands together. Namo Gurudev Namo Namo. Okay. Now, do you want to stay and do a little bit of serious work without all the giggles and laughter, or do you want to pop along and play outside? Because you can choose.
On what?
I really need to have complete concentration, or else I can't do it. I stop the class and we do something else. And I don't want either of you to be poking each other and giggling, because you're going to be doing your own work. Breathe. Laugh as much as you want to, it's okay. Harder. Faster.
Bridget's had enough of Claire and Lorraine acting like children, so she decides to treat them as children and resorts to kids' yoga songs.
Happiness moves in a circular motion. Happiness moves in a circular motion. Life is like a little boat on the sea. Happiness moves in a circular motion. Life is like a little boat on the sea. Everyone is part of everything anyway. You can have it all if you let it be.
Happiness runs in a circular motion. Thought is like a little boat upon the sea.
And let's end by having a hug.
Of everything anyway.
We ought to have 8 hugs a day.
I wasn't quite sure to make of it whether her complete style of teaching had changed completely. But actually I realised afterwards that she was just it was just her partly her way of dealing with the situation or her way of throwing it back on people.
Can't be doing with that humming and all of that. I just don't see the point in it. That don't do anything for me.
But Reese and Yasmin Jeffries are getting something out of the yoga.
It was funny.
Because we have to go. Life goes round in a round circle. Life's like a boat in the middle of the sea.
Now, everybody, please, please make sure that when you go to France, you only visit the south, like Saint-Tropez and Monaco.
Lovely.
The best place to be. Don't come here. Because you're not allowed to eat no meat. You're only allowed to eat nuts. What's it called here?
I don't know. The dustbin or something.
Waheguru, Waheguru, Waheguru. The next morning, none of the Jeffreys have made it to yoga. As a men's counsellor, Chris is used to dealing with problems. Aware there is a lack of peace, love and understanding between the families, he gets everyone together for a meeting.
We would normally just check out how everybody is and what they're enjoying, what they're not enjoying. And also just how are you settling in? Are you getting anything out of it or, you know?
To be honest, it's not a holiday we would normally do.
This could be 2 miles down the road, couldn't it, from where we live?
Yeah, because it is very similar to where we live. You know what I'm like? I'm a real sun worshipper. If there was sun, I'd be in my element. That's what's getting me down more than anything at the moment, that we're sort of trying to find things to do.
I don't feel it's a holiday at all. I think I'd be better off at home decorating or something. I'd have much more fun. I've been absolutely bored, stiff.
What do you actually feel that you need as far as diet goes?
Just a decent hot meal.
Well, I don't think we can really alter the, you know, the character of this place is that it's basically vegetarian. It's good, quite high quality food. I don't think we can do anything about that. And they basically have local wine, but they don't have anything else here. So that's more or less a given.
I'd rather be sat in cat's than be here.
I'm still determined to find a dictionary somewhere to see what the meaning of holiday is, because I can't say that this is it.
It's boot camp.
Yeah, I wouldn't do it.
The sun comes out and tensions begin to evaporate.
Rowing, rowing forward and rowing back.
Lorraine starts to enjoy the yoga.
Breathing in and I'm breathing out.
I wanted to carry on with the yoga because I just feel that I wanted to make sure that I get the exercises right. So if I do get a chance at home to sort of incorporate it with the exercises I already do in the morning, then it's going to do me good. So hopefully I will be able to carry it on.
And after a glass of organic wine, she opens up.
If I was totally honest with you, it's a society thing for me. I'm big, I'm loud and in your face. But I can't do something like that that I think is going to make me look stupid.
Other people will judge you on it because of what they think.
Yeah.
Concerned that Richard is still refusing to do the yoga, Chris takes him up a mountain for some male bonding.
It's mainly breathing, to be honest.
Yeah.
Mainly breathing.
Yeah. It does interest me. It's just sort of, I don't know, I suppose I just feel a bit embarrassed about doing it. I might surprise you. I might turn up in the morning. Yeah, we'll see if I can build some courage up and come.
How many Jack Daniels do you think that takes?
Yeah, I haven't seen any of that recently.
Chris is determined to unite the families and has invited peace dancing teacher Josine Zon to lead a dance.
Anybody wants to do it, come and do it.
As a bodyguard, peace dancing is not something Richard wants to do, but he is prepared to watch and he's found a partner in crime in Nathan Seck.
This should be good.
There is just nothing to do. It's a barren wasteland of anti-fun. And it's just a load of nonsense, really.
Peace be with you, and with you be peace.
Chris's plan has worked. At last, the Jeffreys are smiling.
I've enjoyed today. You're tired, aren't you?
I am, Chris.
All that dancing, both.
Yeah.
I suppose I can say that it started to flow today, and from being kind of a wheel that wasn't turning, it started actually turning.
I would like to get everyone to get to final yoga class, but more than getting them to the yoga class would be for them to enjoy the yoga class, because in some ways if you get somewhere you don't really want to be there, it's not that relevant really to me.
Tomorrow is Richard's last chance to try yoga. Coming up, face to face at the final supper, Claire gets a few home truths.
Is you hurting people okay all the time just because you want to be you?
The Furniture Village summer sale is on now, and I love the way it surprises me. I love the fact they know their furniture inside out, and I know I'm making a real saving on everything, including some great British brands. And with free delivery on everything too, I really love that moment when you find just what you're looking for. The Furniture Village summer sale. Where else?
Yep.
Rounding up this female red Riddler. Whatever you do, don't make a sound.
Sorry, mate.
They're nutty.
Kellogg's Crunchy Nut. Delicious nutty flakes drizzled in honey. The trouble is, they taste too good.
I like this orange juice with bits. And I also like this one. Look, you can see the bits. Reminds me, the shorts on those sprinters, much too tight.
Here's some facts on how you can help prevent climate change and save money at the same time. How? With double glazing from SafeStyle UK.
Facts!
State-of-the-art double glazing systems could help reduce your carbon household emissions by 2/3 of a tonne a year.
Facts!
It could reduce heat loss through your windows by half, saving you money on energy bills.
Facts!
Right now there's a massive 55% off everything and we'll beat any genuine like-for-like quote.
Plus there's free fitting too, and that's a fact. So call now on 0800 106 107 for your free quotation.
I got a feeling that I just can't explain. My head feels so good, I'll wash it all again.
Have you tried new Vosine? Families have trusted Vosine for generations to help keep their hair and scalp healthy, clean and feeling great. And now there's a whole new range to suit everyone. So whoever you are, you can't help but sing. For healthy looking hair and scalp, you can trust Vosine.
I've had an accident, and I think I should get some compensation.
Don't make me laugh, underdog.
OK, then. I'll call National Accident Helpline. Their solicitors will sort everything out for me, and I get 100% compensation, because the other side pays all the costs.
The other side pays all the costs?
You're not laughing there, are you?
However big they are, call National Accident Helpline on 0800
556 557. Or go to underdog.co.uk.
Hungry? Well, at hungryhouse.co.uk, there's a world of local takeaways delivering to your door. Chinese, Indian pizza, Thai, sushi and more. There's over 6,000 menus nationwide. To order your delivery, simply click the menu, then check out in seconds. hungryhouse.co.uk. Order online or download the free app.
Munch Bunch Squashums!
Good morning, sir. How can I help you today?
I'd like strawberries and milk, please.
Certainly. Here you go. Enjoy.
What's this?
Munch Bunch Squashums are fun, squeezable yogurts with delicious fruit and milk. Great for growing kids. Munch Bunch Squashums from Nestle.
It's the final day of the Sec family holiday in the Pyrenees and the last yoga class. Chris has slept outside with his favourite tree. Being at one with the elements gives him time to think. He has doubts about whether all the Jeffreys will make it to yoga.
They've probably got something from being here, but I don't know whether they've actually come in contact with what to me is kind of the fundamental quality of the place.
But Lorraine is rallying up her family.
Come on then, let me get up.
Why?
Because it's the last yoga session, I want everyone there.
And that includes Richard.
I suppose it must have a feel-good factor to it. Otherwise, people wouldn't do it, I suppose. So I'll give it a go and see what happens.
And for the first time, it's a full house for yoga.
Yellow is the colour of my true love's here in the morning. When we rise in the morning.
There was a lot of humming going on, most of it was my feet.
It definitely works, I think. It's had to do with feeling the vibration through your body.
Yeah.
I've got something indoors, I've got a few things indoors that I can feel the vibration through my body with.
It's the end of the holiday. Time for some straight talking.
I enjoyed the villa. I thought the villa was very good.
Best thing of the holiday for me was definitely, absolutely definitely, without a doubt, was Chris doing karaoke.
It was absolutely priceless.
It was nice to see him relax and just explore new things and going to new territory. And
it's all about just going out and having a laugh. Just do whatever, but as long as you have a laugh.
Yeah.
But Claire didn't do much laughing on the second holiday.
I don't think I really have got any good points about your holiday, to be honest.
To me, the difficulty about the second holiday was that I felt that the respect and the honouring that we showed your holiday wasn't returned back. Not you, Lorraine, because I felt most of the time you were really respecting and honouring the people and the place as it was, but I did feel that certainly you a lot were really putting the place down and not able to appreciate it, yeah. Saying, this is not this meal.
But that's just me, though. I can't say, ooh, this is different. I say, oh, this is because that's me.
Is you hurting people okay all the time just because you want to be you?
I'm a very selfish person. I don't think about other people. I think about myself. And I admit that.
To be perfectly honest, I will be sorry to go home tomorrow. You know. No, seriously. I mean, I'd much rather be in Menorca, but the yoga opened my eyes to the fact that, yeah, I can get fit. I'm fed up with getting up in the morning and being so tired. I mean, I bite his head off so much. I don't think I've done it at all this week, have I, in the mornings?
It just makes you realise that nothing else matters, I think. That you can just get out in the sun and enjoy just being alive. If the place where it was would have had a swimming pool and
was allowed to eat what we like,
had normal food, it would have been heaven.
But I just want to just celebrate you anyway for having joined our holiday to whatever extent you did, and just to thank you.
And you too.
And you too. Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers.
For both families, it's been an extraordinary experience. Now they're going their separate ways.
Home.
Goodbye, young man.
See you later. Take care. Thank you for your holiday. In the morning.
When I've definitely got something out of this holiday. You know, to realise that probably exercise is an important factor in life.
I kind of come away feeling that we've touched, you know, we've actually had experiences together and we've made contact. I feel that I've made contact with all of them. In the morning, when we rise, in the
morning, when we rise. We're about to book our villa holiday for next year, so if you'd like to come,
the offers there. So we're organising a family holiday in Lavaldia next year, for families who want to come and join us. So if you want to come, you'll be really most welcome to come and be with us if you feel like you'd like to try it again.
Your holiday really did change our lives. We've given up smoking, we are now vegetarians, and we do yoga 3 times a week.
Not! Bond is back. Daniel Craig is blowing stuff up all over the place tonight at 9 in Quantum of Solace. Next here this afternoon, though, it's your chance to catch up with all the acts in Double America's Got Talent.